race?
Keep up.
How many times are you going to get pissed at me this week?
That depends on you, and how well you do in this phase of the test. Welcome to American Rust, my home away from hell.
Raw and rough. It suits you.
Max, do you know how awesome this is? I get my best friend back, and she's also super-sized?
We don't know.
Seems pretty regular size to me.
Exactly why it's time to have powers. Fun.
Kidding? After yesterday, I'm kind of over guns, Chloe. Freaks me out that you have one.
Don't you trust me?
Yes.
No.
Not that gun.
You have more power than an army. Don't be scared of my little toy. Besides, we need it for the test.
Great. What test is this? Can you stop a bolt before it shoots you in the head?
You are so cute. You haven't changed a bit.
I mean, I already know what the test actually is, but...
Can you find 5 bottles while I prep the shooting range?
Beer and guns? Nice combo.
You can handle it. Now go find us 5 bottles, pretty please.
Alright, fine. I'll find the bottles. If I can remember where they are. Right off the bat, there's one right there.
Stupid bottle.
And I remember... Oh yeah, box. The bottle will not escape me.
Hello, bottle number 1. 4 more to go.
Alright, one other thing I have to get while I'm here. Oh, wait. Bottle. I didn't even go look for that one.
Boom.
I actually forgot about that one.
Only 3 bottles left. Wowzer. That looks exactly like the same dough from my tornado vision. That dough is the perfect photo op.
But isn't it like a ghost, so, or something? It's, what's the word? Ethereal? So your picture's gonna be... nothing. Right there.
So quiet and primordial out here. I always feel like the forest is whispering to me. Like Arcadia Bay is trying to tell me something. I just have to figure out the message.
I think everybody feels that way when they kind of sit down and take in their surroundings. Just to stop and think. But whatever. Well, I definitely know this is a picture, because I saw the 142 there.
This was an old school punk shirt. No way! I totally remember going there when I was a kid. I loved the Hush Puppies. Now the sign is just Arcadia Bay junk.
Yeah, I know how that is. I remember a few restaurants from when I was a kid that, they're gone now. I miss Jasper's. Let's see here. Get a picture of the bus. Oh, here. Photo. Now where were the rest of the bottles? What the fuck?
Aw, poor thing.
Now, if that isn't the creepiest looking little thing. Use that doll right, it could be the scariest motherfucking thing you'll ever see in your entire life.
This looks like a graffiti museum for Chloe and Rachael. I bet I can find out more about Rachael here.
This place was nice. Oh, they're playing darts and... Rachael was kicking Chloe's ass. Holy crap.
That kind of hurts. I can't see Chloe playing with makeup. They really were besties. That could have been me instead of Rachael. Rachael songs. I wonder if Chloe would ever make me a mixtape.
Yeah. Fuck you. Yes, you.
Ouch.
I wonder who that was for. Lala land this way. Ooh, bottle.
Three down, two more to go. Talk about finding a bottle in a haystack. I want to die. Jeez. Who wrote this?
I'm guessing Chloe. I went for more, fuck life days.
So Rachael did go to a Vortex Club party. This flyer is dated right before she disappeared.
Hmm. DJ Irish Bacon. What the fuck? Some DJ names, man. Freaking weird as fuck.
Now we're officially a trio. We just have to find Rachael.
That's gonna have consequences.
I don't want to intrude, but I was here.
I really want to know, like, sometimes I see these, as I say, there's going to be consequences for what you did, but I never actually get to see what the outcome of the consequences are. Why they never come up. Hello, little squirrel. What are you doing? Are you the squirrel I was looking to get a picture of the other day? You suck. All I'm going to say. Oh, fuck. Oh, it's just a tire iron.
I'm sure this is a popular party pit.
This is the kind of area where I'd probably sit and do whatever.
One more bottle to go.
You know what's weird? That just fell and I rewound it. Now nothing's making it fall. Like, seriously, look. What? So what is it that I did there that made it fall, but it didn't fall a second ago? That's some bullshit. That's all I'm gonna say about that. Washing machine.
I wonder if Chloe thinks about her father when she looks at all these smashed up cars.
Well, that isn't the most depressing thing I've heard all day. We got four bottles. Look for one last one. The fuck?
Those shells look fresh.
So we're fucking around with a revolver. Somebody was fucking around with a shotgun. Let's just hope we don't end up trying to shoot each other. I think I remember the last bottle was up here somewhere.
Where there's a boat, there's a pirate. which means booze bottles.
Huh? Oh, all right.
Way heavier than I thought. Ugh.
Now, the last bottle.
Voila. Now I can deliver this bottle booty to Captain Chloe.
You take a sit while I...
This junkyard is a dive. I see why Chloe hangs here.
Yeah, it's nice.
She's a steampunk. It actually feels like Chloe and I are kids again. We're hiding out and plotting our future. Despite all the chaos and bullshit, I feel so giddy hanging out with her again. So happy. Like we've both gone back in time.
Yeah. That nice feeling, isn't it? You sit there while I check the photos, though. Only one more photo here, I think. Let's cross the blank.
Thanks, Max.
Yes, have a couple more drinks before you
wait,
fire off that gun.
Road?
You're serious about this?
We're gonna shoot all these bottles without wasting a single bullet. Max, you have to help me aim.
Fine.
Show me the way, Max.
I need to see you shoot first.
Come on. Alright.
Show me the way, Max.
Aim a bit to the right.
Sir, yes, sir.
This reminds me of,
Oh, yes! Did you see that shit, Max?
Duh.
The Walking Dead Season 1.
That was so fucking cool.
When you're teaching Clementine
how
to
second bottle.
Shoot a gun.
Now, Max, where do I aim?
You're on target. Pull the trigger.
Now, Max, where do I
aim? Slightly above.
Right between the eyes. Watch out, Nathan. Now that is fun. Let's pump up the volume and find me another target. I want to get creative here. Give me something to shoot, Max. Hello, what should I shoot?
Shoot the rim.
Let's take out this wheel rim on your left.
Taking out the wheel rim now? Hella yes!
Nice shooting, Tech.
Now that's what I'm talking about.
Satisfied?
Like never. So I want one more uber cool trick shot.
How about using that junker for a target now?
Alright.
Dude, I need a target before I shoot.
I'm gonna tell her to shoot the bumper just because she's been a little bitch the whole time here.
Put a real dent in that.
I know she's being
bumper.
Stupid.
Goodbye, cruel bumper. Jesus, I shot myself!
Stupid gun! Hold on, Chloe.
Dude,
how about aiming for the left tire?
Adios, spinning wheel of death.
That was awesome.
Super cool. I cannot believe this is for reals. My best friend is a superhero. Now it's your turn to bust a cap.
I don't know.
Max, your nose. Damn.
I don't feel so super.
Max!
was interesting.
You freaked me out there. Do you feel any better now?
A little. Thanks for helping me. Just give me a minute.
Too much action for Arcadia?
Maybe not enough. This is kind of fun. Scary and stupid, but fun.
Let me know when you feel okay.
God, this power really messes with my head. Glad I feel normal again. I better go chat up Chloe.
Yeah. That's just how it is with psychic powers, isn't it? In like shows and that. It always messes with your head if you use it too much. That's what she's got. Freaking chronokinesis.
Okay. Looks like you're ready to lock and load.
I don't know about this.
Are you afraid of getting in trouble?
Oh, boo-hoo. Max is afraid.
I know you can handle this. And I'm here to guide you. Make me proud, sister.
Hey, it's Thelma and Louise. Or is it Bonnie and Clyde?
Excuse us, Frank.
Oh, sorry, Chloe. Don't let me get in the way of your bonding. I heard the gunshots and the breaking glass. It's cute that you're playing with guns. Just like me at your age.
We're not anything alike, man.
We both need money. In fact, you need it so bad, you owe me a shitload, don't you, Chloe? Huh?
You'll get your money.
Don't they all say that? You know, even when they're broke and acting tough? What are you hiding there, girlie? Let me see.
That's creepy, man.
Where did you get that bracelet?
A friend, and it's none of your goddamn business. You're my business now.
That's Rachel's bracelet. Why the fuck are you wearing her bracelet?
Calm yourself, all right? It was a gift.
No, it wasn't. You stole that shit. Give it to me right now, asshole.
You better step back before you regret it, girl. I mean it. You want me to cut you, bitch?
Please. Please step back.
You're kidding. Put that down. That is hilarious. Oh, man. I'll remember you, kid. I'll remember you almost shot me. And you'll wish I had no memory, because I never forget. You have until Friday to pay me. Don't ever pull crap like this again. It'll be the last time you do. Try bullets next time, brainiacs.
Well, we had both, but Chloe used them all shooting beer bottles.
Sorry.
You are awesome. Thanks for standing up for me. Let's blow. My secret lair didn't feel secret today. At least Frank is gone. He won't fuck with us again. He just wants his money.
Jesus, I almost shot this guy. And now he'll be more dangerous to Chloe and me.
Don't worry, we can deal with him. Now,
Chloe's like, wow, sir. Why did Frank have Rachel's bracelet? We need to talk about this later, but I better follow Chloe now.
Yeah, let's walk down the train tracks. What could possibly go wrong?
I still can't believe you pulled a gun on Frank. That was epic.
It felt awful. I'm glad there was no bullets in there.
You can just rewind time in your hand and stick that barrel right up Frank's ass. You have the power!
You're gross. Don't fall.
I'm just glad you were here.
Me too. I think. Chloe, why the hell are you hanging around scary losers like Frank? It's weird.
Let's take a break and I'll talk. Feels like a different world, huh? I wish we could stay forever.
Can we build another pirate fort and keep the world out?
We need a new secret hangout. At least Frank wouldn't find us. Are you okay, Max?
Seriously, Chloe, this is scary. What if Frank tries to track us down?
I'm sorry, but Frank isn't as hardcore as he fronts. All he cares about is his cash, stash, and mangy dog.
Chloe, did you see what just happened? I almost shot him. I know I could rewind, but Chloe, this is not playtime. No more guns.
Max, I know. Crazy shit is the new normal for me. That's why I plan to leave Arcadia Bay without paying Frank off.
Now, tell me exactly what's going on between you and Frank. Does he have a last name?
Frank Bowers, he's just a dealer where I get my weed. The one in your joint, remember? Anyway, Frank and I kind of hung out.
Hung out? You don't mean you...
No, we didn't have sex. Gross, man. He never even tried. I just made the mistake of borrowing money so Rachel and I could bail out of here.
That's it?
No. I want to know how Frank got Rachel's bracelet. What do you think?
Be careful, honestly. That's the best thing I can come up with.
I think we have to be careful and keep an eye on this guy.
That's the guy, a switchblade. Pretty sure he ended up getting shanked.
It's so weird talking to you about this insane crap.
Or shot if he has a gun.
We haven't hung out this much since we were tweens, and it's like no time has passed. I wish Rachel was here to meet you.
Do you think that Rachel and I would have been friends?
You're not that different. She had... has a great eye for images and for art. Plus, she's a smartass like you. We would all be hella best friends forever.
I know she must be as cool as you are. I have no doubt we'll meet soon.
Railroad tracks always make me feel better. I have no idea why.
Kerouac knew. It's the romance of travel and movement. The sound of the train whistle at night.
Look at the beat poet here.
I'd rather be a good photographer.
You are. You just have to stop being afraid.
Perfect.
Than a life of what ifs. Oh. Yeah, pretty sure that's about right.
I can definitely use this bad boy.
Come on, Max. Oh no, I was thinking we'll just sitting here having a cup of coffee and, you know, letting you get run over by a train.
Score.
I'm pretty sure it was this one. Wrong. Okay. There we go.
I can pull a total MacGyver.
The train's coming! Max, please!
Okay.
Max, get me out of here!
Awesome, it's not locked.
Now, I think it was the red wire.
Which wire to cut?
Please.
Now that's the right cable. Yes, I did it!
Damn right we did.
You okay?
You saved me again. Crazy. Now we're totally bonded for life.
Damn. That was close.
Aren't you glad I took you away to a nice, quiet, desolate spot?
It was cool to spend time in your lair, but I have to get back to school before my next class.
Since you're the mysterious superhero, I'll be your faithful chauffeur and companion.
Yes, a nice, quiet, might not desolate rest, spot.
To That's okay.
Die by a train.
We will. Forever. Thanks for the ride, Chloe. Right on time for my art lesson.
Thanks for coming with me. Sorry to be so boring.
Nothing exciting ever happens to us, right?
Listen, your rewind power has to be connected to that snow yesterday. That might explain your tornado vision.
Explain what?
Explain what? Snow equals a ginormous twister that takes out Arcadia Bay? You're high.
Wake up, Max. You saved my life twice now. You altered the course of my destiny, yours, and whoever. Do you know about chaos theory?
What do you know about chaos theory, Miss I Hate Math?
5 years ago, asswipe. Some people change. And your situation is the perfect storm for quantum physics.
Why me? I'm just a geek girl in some small town.
A perfect example of strange attractors? Don't they teach you kids anything at Blackwell? We have a tornado, rewind power, and freak snow. Hello, Armageddon. So let's party with your power, Rockstar!
Like he said, Professor Price, a superhero needs a sidekick.
How can it be such a shitty week, and yet one of the best of my life?
Because we're back in action again.
Okay, you know what? Something I should say, especially after watching that little conversation. This game is awesome. I love the story and everything. But does anyone besides me honestly find the lip syncing, or like how it seems like they never really seem to they never really exaggerate some of the facial expressions. It's not a wide variety of facial expressions when someone's talking, like the lip syncing, the lips are out of sync, and
I can do some wonders.
Like even when someone's yelling, the lip movement looks like they should just be talking normally.
So are you going to that party?
That kind of bothers me a bit.
Like I would miss it. I have this.
Excuse me, Mr. Madsen.
I know things got a little heated yesterday in Chloe's room. Was that really your reefer?
No.
No, it belonged to a friend of mine. Are you going to bust me now, Mr. Madsen?
Even I'm not that much of an asshole. And I am sorry about yesterday. I was wrong, but upset. Cannabis is not a big deal to you, but it has been to Chloe.
You're a combat veteran. She's no threat to you.
If I didn't care about her, I wouldn't care at all. When I was her age, I was out raising a lot more hell. She's better than that. All you kids are. So is Kate Marsh.
But you treat Kate pretty bad.
You step between us at a pretty bad time. She's another matter entirely.
Kate hasn't done anything wrong.
Max, this isn't just about Kate Marsh. My concern is for the safety of all Blackwell students, including you.
That'll take more than surveillance cameras.
It will take more than Ms. Grant and her petition to find missing students.
Isn't that your responsibility as head of security? Unless you know something about Rachael Amber that nobody else does.
I don't want to fight with you anymore. I don't want to fight with anyone anymore. That's all, Max.
Yeah, this is part of the reason why, honestly, I don't hate David. My opinion of David has always generally been that he's a guy whose heart's in the right place, but he's just a little too eager to deal with shit. He's overzealous. Plus, this is kind of what you get for, you know, putting a soldier in the position of a security guard.
I could go see Warren playing mad scientist in the lab.
I mean, honestly, when you put a soldier in the position of a security guard, that's kind of what you get. It's like trying to use an atom bomb as weed killer.
Hey, Warren. Are you okay? You look thoughtful yet confused.
Maxwell Silverhammer. Perfect timing. I need help with this chemical experiment.
Asking me for help means you're screwed.
I have to add either a bit of potassium or sodium. It's up to you to decide. Dr. Max?
I have a vision. Godium.
Godium? That's the worst pun I've ever heard. Yet Max has spoken. Sodium it is.
Let's see how this goes.
Damn. Zip. Nothing. Nada. This can't be that hard.
Now, I know the proper answer, but I know I have to talk to Miss Grant in order to get the proper answer, so.
Miss Grant is so cool and smart. She defines the word teacher.
Okay, how do I talk to her?
Hi,
I'm in front of the desk, okay.
Funny, I was just thinking about you, Max. Thanks again for taking a stand against camera surveillance here. Every signature counts.
Miss Grant, can I ask you a possibly dumb science question?
You know my stock teacher answer. There are no dumb questions. Ask away.
Would you add potassium or sodium to a chemical mix for this week's experiment?
Neither, unless you want a face full of powder. I would add chlorine.
Okay. Here.
I'm just thinking about all the autumn photos I want to take.
Oh, this is my favorite time of year. I do love the season change. This whole campus is a visual delight. I know Mr. Jefferson loves to shoot around here.
You must know Mr. Jefferson pretty well by now.
I certainly know him as a talented artist and terrific teacher. I've been here a little longer, but he's made a bigger mark. I have to say, it's not quite autumn enough yet.
I can't wait for fall either. It's all about the atmosphere.
You're the artist and I'm the scientist. Like yin and yang.
I'm sorry, Miss Grant, but I have to get going.
Go on, Max. We'll talk again. Real soon.
Okay, then.
Hey, Warren.
Maxwell.
Let's skip.
Asking me to
have that either.
You're not adding sodium or potassium, you dumb shit. You're adding chlorine.
Wrong, Warren. You need to add chlorine. Not potassium or sodium.
Chlorine? I didn't think of that. Can't argue with a confident scientist. Let's try it.
Let's see. Ooh.
Eureka! She's got it.
No, you got it.
Don't be so modest, Dr. Caulfield.
There. One more photo.
You look worried. Is everything okay?
Sorry to bother you, Mr. Jefferson.
I'm only bothered when you avoid turning in photos. But you know this. So what can I do for you, Max?
Just between you and me, I'm worried about Kate Marsh.
That's no secret. Word on the street is that you and Kate had a little confrontation with our security chief yesterday.
I stepped in between David Madsen barking all up in Kate's face about something. She doesn't deserve that.
Of course not. Mr. Madsen isn't the most gentle soul. Do you have proof he instigated the situation?
My word isn't good enough? The one time I choose not to take a picture.
Always take the shot. My number one rule of photography. And Max, I promise this matter is being discussed by the faculty. I assume you know about this viral video?
Yeah. Kate's freaked about it. By the way, I don't know. Anyone else think it's weird? The one thing I kind of noticed that some of the characters in this game keep on this here, what he just did. What's up with the characters always doing this little, like, reach up and, like, brush their cheek thing? What is with that? What is that? Because every character does it. I don't know what the fuck that is with that.
Kate is freaked out by all of this. She can't do homework while she's being tormented on a daily basis.
What if Kate brought this on herself? She means well, but maybe she doth protest too much. She seems like she's holding back the truth. Have you talked to her?
Yes, I talked to her on the phone today. She needs friends and support now. I just don't want Kate Marsh to become the next Rachael Amber.
Rachael Amber? What does she have to do with Kate?
With all her missing persons posters around, it's hard not to think of her.
I miss Rachael too. But think about yourself, Max. Principal Wells told me about what you said happened in the bathroom.
Oh, for the love of fuck.
It did happen. Nathan Prescott had a gun in the girls' bathroom yesterday.
This is a serious accusation, Max.
So you don't believe me? I would never make something like this up.
I hope so, Max. But it's easy to point fingers. If Mr. Madsen claims you might be a pot dealer as he did, should I believe him?
Listen, should I...
Excuse me, Max. Hello? Yes? Hold on. I have to take this, so just go into class and I'll be there soon.
Do you think Max will be pissed we're sitting at her desk?
Oh, I'm sure she'll report us to the principal. But better be quiet, Victoria. We have a master snitch and liar here.
Did you think we were best
snitch,
friends
maybe.
Forever or
liar?
Something?
That's you, pal.
Not at all, Victoria.
Max is such an attention whore.
You would pot calling the kettle black, pal.
Can I sit down now?
Oh, please do. Take a selfie of this moment.
Yeah, Max, so I won't forget you.
Breck.
Assholes.
His ass should be shot or beat down, honestly.
Okay, why is David taking photos of Kate? Now this is so wrong and weird.
Okay. Shitheads talking. They're doing a photo shoot. Oh, here comes Warren.
What up, Max?
Hey, Warren.
I saw Kate earlier and her eyes were puffy from crying.
Kate has a lot on her plate.
I didn't know what to say and she didn't tell me anything.
Okay, I know you love me, but if you're not in this class, beat it. Everybody else, please sit
Maybe
down.
I'll see
we have
you
a lot to cover today and so little time as usual. I see all the usual suspects here. Anybody seen Kate Marsh?
I think everybody has seen Kate Marsh by now.
She's not feeling good.
Sounds like you're giggling about a video gone viral. Maybe it involves a student or a friend. I wonder how it would feel to have false images of yourself shot out all over the world for people to judge. Usually, no smartphones in class, Max. Put that away. People need something to judge, so they never take a good look at themselves.
What's your problem? My sentiments exactly.
We can thank reality TV for some of that. In the end, we can only blame ourselves for participating. Speaking of participation, there are a few souls here who have yet to enter a photo in the contest. Like Max Caulfield, for example. Who I know can't wait to enter, right? I'm sure you read the syllabus like it was a Harry Potter book, so you must know today we're studying chiaroscuro. That beautiful word about the contrast between light and dark. The shadow play that gives photography such visual power. It's basic yin and yang. Black and white images are effective precisely because of their contrast. Although we don't technically see in my...
Yo! Some crazy shit is going down in the girl's dorm!
Zachary, do not come into my class like that ever again. Listen! Everybody remain seated.
Nobody listens.
Dismissed.
Honestly, the fact that he says nobody leave the room and they all just completely disregard him, that makes me laugh every time.
Is this for real?
It slipped out.
I didn't think she was that messed up.
Oh, shit. Here we go.
She can't die. She can't.
I hope not.
have to try something. I won't be able to rewind again and again.
All right, come on. I remember the first time I played this, I thought this part was awesome.
Max, you can do it.
The only sad part is this is like the only time in the game you do this. I was kind of hoping it was like a new unlocked power or something. But no, it's just a one-time thing. But man, is it awesome. Like, everything's just frozen. Yeah. You just keep running, David. Just keep running.
Yes.
Doing here, Max? Stop! Don't come near me!
Not now. It won't work. I have to do this by myself.
Max, seriously,
why doesn't
don't
Kate question why Max is like her hand out and just
okay.
Twitching and
I'm right here.
Jerking back.
Kate, please.
Oh, Max, I know you want to help me. I love that you stepped up to David, but it doesn't matter now. Nothing matters.
You matter, and not just to me.
I do want to believe that.
Kate, your life is still yours, and we can get through this together. Let me help, like I helped by erasing all that crap people wrote on your room slate.
I'm glad to hear you worry about me. That makes me feel better.
And this is where a lot of your actions from even episode one and earlier in this episode, going through all of Kate's stuff in her room really helps out. Because this makes this a lot easier.
Of course I worry. You're my friend, Kate.
I did feel better talking to you on the phone. I always feel like you really listen.
Kate, please trust me. Come stand by me, okay? I can help you now. I know I can. This morning I erased the web link to the video. It was written on the shower room mirror.
That's your story now. How can I trust you? What about this morning when I needed help? You told me to do nothing.
Kate, I'm gathering proof that Nathan Prescott drugged you. And you're not the only victim. So you have to help me take Nathan down.
Nathan Prescott? That makes sense. He's a scumbag. You have proof now?
Soon, then straight to the police. Think of it like we're cleansing Blackwell.
You do have my back, Max. That's the first time I've felt hopeful in a week.
Good. We all need to have each other's backs. So, I want you to come with me now. Please, you don't have to do this.
Max, I'm in a nightmare and I can't wake up. Unless I put myself to sleep. Then everybody at Blackwell can post pics of my body. I'm horny on the internet forever. No wonder they call it a web. Nothing can ever get out. Like my video. I wish I could go back in time and erase everything.
Nobody cares, Kate. There'll be another viral Victoria video in a day and everybody will forget.
It's true.
You can't scrub my video from the internet. And that's how I'll be remembered. Unless I jump.
Kate, you can't do this to all the people who care about you.
No, nobody cares about me. Nobody.
Kate, this will crush your father. You think he cares about a video? He loves you unconditionally.
dad does care, even though I hurt him. He's the only one I know who believes in me.
See? You're not alone. And nobody down there wants to see you up here. This isn't the end, Kate. There's no way God doesn't have big plans for you here.
Nice try, Max. But God put me on this roof.
Come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest.
Matthew 11:28. I can't believe you quoted one of my favorite passages.
Like I said, I care about you. I know this passage means a lot to you.
I'm sorry. Sorry.
What are you talking about? You saved me from talking in class.
Well, I'm glad that ended happily. Or at least positively. Not sure if we'd say it was happy.
Now, I know today was difficult for everybody. But I'm so proud of the way Blackwell pulled together to save a young girl's life. Of course, you're quite a hero for getting Kate to come down, Max.
I didn't do much.
She's modest. Like a real hero.
Yeah, real hero.
As principal of Blackwell Academy, I take my duties seriously.
I smell a certain degree of disdain in what David just said.
What happened today should never happen in a hall of wisdom and knowledge. Mr. Madsen, as our head of security here, those roof doors should always be locked. That's just standard operating procedure. They were not.
And yeah, why is that, David?
Your responsibility. Mr. Jefferson, I know you can't be expected to know what your students are going through, but Kate has assisted you in class, so you should have known something was amiss. Mr. Prescott, since you are responsible for the Vortex Club parties, and since Miss Marsh did attend your last party, you'll have to answer some more questions. Miss Caulfield, why exactly were you on the roof with Kate Marsh? Did she tell you her plan? Or anything at all? Please, tell us everything.
Nathan Doster, Jefferson made her cry, David Bloiter. I'm not really sure about Jefferson making her cry. David did bully her. But I think the most severe one is Nathan. So,
all I know is that Kate Nathan. Was at a party and Nathan dosed her. She got wasted and
video games I've played in a long time. Can't wait to get to the next episode. Alright. See what we got here. Told Kate to wait for proof. 70% of people did that. 30% told her to go to the police. Eh. Answer Kate's call. 70% did that. Try to shoot Frank. 52% of people did that. almost an even split on that one. But just a slightly bit more tried to kill Frank. Didn't succeed, but we tried. The only reason I tried to shoot him was because I knew there was no bullet in it, but I wonder how many people actually tried to shoot him not knowing there was no bullets in the gun. 57 saved Kate. 72% of people blame Nathan. Saw that coming. Alright. Watered your plant. Didn't help Alyssa. Honestly, I was questioning that. Like, I know I was supposed to help Alyssa, but I didn't see them. Nobody opened the bathroom door and threw the toilet paper out like they usually do. Here's Link Kate's video. You're friendly with Taylor. Most people didn't do that. I guess most people just hate Victoria and her friends. You accepted Warren's invitation. Wrote a message. I told David. Helped Warren. You gained entry to the Vortex Club party. Wow, that one's like, that one's actually an even split. 50-50, right down the middle. Damn. You know, I actually found out a lot of the time people don't do these ones. Like, they didn't help Alyssa or they didn't help Warren. It's mostly because they didn't know where to go or that they could do that. They never looked around to find it. Kind of shows you what you get for not exploring.